Good morning and welcome to worship with Shadyside Presbyterian Church. We are so blessed to be able to gather in this manner for worship, and we ask that you sign our virtual pew pad if you have not yet done so. Please see your bulletin for our upcoming food and coat drive for East End Cooperative Ministry and Veterans Place of Pittsburgh. We have scheduled times for you to drop off donations here at the church, where pastors and staff will greet you while social distancing with one another. We certainly look forward to seeing you. Recently, you likely received a letter from our COVID task force sharing the news that we will be returning to limited on-site worship here in our sanctuary beginning next Sunday. We are requiring pre-registration for those choosing to attend. Information highlighting protocols and registration directions can be found in today's bulletin. We are very excited for this opportunity, yet we also know that our entire community will not yet be able to gather together completely. If you are high risk, showing symptoms, or if you interact among gatherings of people, we encourage you to consider your own and one another's health prior to registration. And please be reminded that in addition to our on-site worship, we will continue offering this pre-recorded worship service until we are equipped to video live stream our on-site worship service in the future. So whether here in our sanctuary or in your home, we look forward to gathering together with you next Sunday as well. Now let us join our hearts and our voices in today's call to worship. Praise the Lord.
How good it is to sing praises to our God.
For God is gracious, and a song of praise is fitting. The Lord gathers the outcast and heals the brokenhearted. Come, let us worship God.
Thank you.
The mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting. In embracing the promise and assurance of God's mercy, let us confess our sin together. God of our future, you are coming in power to make all things new. We confess that we often fail to live in expectation of your coming, distracted and cautious. We allow our hope to wither, our vision to narrow, and our love to grow cold. In your mercy, forgive us. Grant us courage to welcome your way and to seek the things that will endure when Christ comes to judge the world. Amen. Hear the good news. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into this world to save sinners. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, that we may be dead to sin and alive to all that is good. Believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven.
Let us pray. All gracious God, speak to us by the power of your Holy Spirit. Speak to us when we experience certainty and joy. Speak to us when we are confronted with uncertainty and fear. Only open our hearts and minds to hear and know your voice, for your word is a lamp to our feet and a light unto our path. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from Psalm 78. Hear now the word of God. Give ear, O my people, to my teaching. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings from of old, things that we have heard and known, that our ancestors have told us. We will not hide them from their children. We will tell to the coming generation the glorious deeds of the Lord and his might and the wonders that he has done. He established a decree in Jacob and appointed a law in Israel, which he commanded our ancestors to teach their children, that the next generation might know them, and the children yet unborn, and rise up and tell them to their children, so that they should set their hope in God and not forget the works of God, but keep his commandments. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Reading from Matthew chapter 25, verses 1 through 13, hear God's word. At that time, the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Five of them were foolish, and five were wise. The foolish ones took their lamps, but did not take any oil with them. The wise ones, however, took oil in jars along with their lamps. The bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, the cry rang out, "Here's the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all the virgins woke up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil. Our lamps are going out." "No," they replied, "there may not be enough for both us and you. Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourselves." But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the bridegroom arrived. The virgins who were ready went in with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the others also came. "Lord, Lord," they said, "open the door for us." But he replied, "Truly I tell you, I don't know you. Therefore keep watch, because you do not know the day or the hour." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for the gift of your word, and as we think on these things, open our hearts and our minds to hear you. Amen. In Western Pennsylvania, the name Westinghouse is a household name. George Westinghouse, that inventor extraordinaire, began his electric company here in Pittsburgh in 1886. But 3 years before that, right here in Pittsburgh's East End, the first electric light was installed in a residence by Westinghouse. The location? It was at 410 North Negley Avenue. Now, before that time, light depended on gas or oil or candle power, and then everything changed. I wonder, can we put ourselves back in the days of those light bearers, like the ones we find in our scripture passage? And if we can, are there insights there that we can help us now? This parable that Jesus told about being ready for the bridegroom, of course, makes us think about being ready for Jesus. In fact, it is frequently used as a scripture passage in the Advent season as we watch and wait for Jesus to arrive. However, the lectionary has placed us in advance of Advent, in advance of our celebration of Thanksgiving, by several weeks. So I think we're to make of this the thought that readiness is something we focus on at all times of the year. Being ready for the Lord to arrive, being ready to welcome Him, being ready to enter into His celebration. Such things know no time or season. And in that regard, we don't want to be like those foolish maidens who didn't bring along enough oil to keep their lamps burning. You and I know people like that, people who never think ahead or plan ahead, people who are famous for being spontaneous, maybe also easily distracted, people who wander along through life in a haphazard manner, people who would probably forget to take with them the oil that they need for their lamps. We may enjoy their company from time to time, but even so, we don't want to identify with them when it comes to matters of what we believe and how we put our faith into practice. And since that is the case, we're going to do whatever is needful in order to have plenty of oil in our lamp of faith, in order to keep it burning, in order to see clearly as we watch and wait, in order to be ready. Whenever I consider this parable of the wise and foolish maidens, I am reminded of an absolutely gorgeous illustration that was painted by the artist Maxfield Parrish and called The Lantern Bearers. He painted it in 1908 for Collier's magazine. Now, the painting shows a group of people who are artfully arranged in some garden setting at twilight or a bit later, and they are holding up softly glowing paper lanterns. And the entire scene is illuminated, not by the sun, not by the moon, not by the stars, but by the light that each person is bearing. Now, the picture is beautiful in and of itself and well worth enjoying, but it's even more beautiful because it speaks about where this wonderful light is coming from right there, from each one of those lantern bearers, the light from within. In the context of Jesus' parable, the light bearers played the important function of lighting the way to a celebration that will go on and on. Guess what? The light bearers are each of you and all of you. You have this wonderful opportunity to bear the light of Jesus Christ into the places where it hasn't shined just yet. Now, if we had been reading this parable 200, even 100 years ago, having read it, we might have thought, oh, this is a call to mission, a call to service, a call to action. It still is. It is a call to carry the light of Christ to others, to carry the light of Christ to a family member, to a friend, to carry the light of Christ to people who are fleeing wars or persecution, to show them the way to freedom, the way to the foot of the cross. It's a call to carry the light of Christ to transform the world by your devotion, your service, and your witness. Carry the light of Christ with joy, with thanksgiving, faithfully share the hope that is in you. Carry the light of Christ into the world. The question is, will you? Will you carry the light of Christ within you? Will you embody that light? Will you provide that light wherever you go? There are places in your everyday life that needs Christ's light. Bring it to those places. Let it shine. Did you notice that bridegroom arrived at an unexpected hour? And did you hear that he appeared long after the foolish maidens had lost their light? And yet, those wise maidens, they still had the ability to shine their light. Maybe you find yourself in a place today, a place that is depressing or dismal, a place where the cause of Christ is not championed, a place where the forces of evil seem to have won, a place where insensitivity reigns, a place where manipulative power has become the norm, and it feels like you've been waiting there a long, long time. If we take a look at history, we know that even in the darkest of times, even when the light seems to have gone out entirely, there are still those who bring the light of Christ to bear upon the scene, which makes all the difference in the world. Light bearers. Jesus applies that concept to himself. He says, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. The Dark Ages were truly dark, but they gave way to the light. Today may feel just as dark. Remember to always look for the light. I have a flashlight in my home. I know exactly where it is, and that's good, because when the power goes out, even though I know my home pretty well, I look for the light. I want to see what's happening. I want to know where I am. So before I go very far, I get the flashlight. I turn it on. It helps me get through the next minutes or hours, however long it takes, until the darkness goes away. It does me a lot of good, and it does everyone else in the house a lot of good. That light is great, but then there's that light of Jesus Christ, which is greater by far. The light of Jesus Christ does not depend upon oil or candle power or electricity. Here are some thoughts that come from what you know to be true about the light of Jesus Christ. You awakened to his light. You awakened into his community of faith. You awakened into his community of faith that celebrates diversity and equality and inclusion. You awakened to his community of faith that believes that his good news is about drawing his circle of love larger and larger. You awakened to his community of faith, a one that builds bridges, not barriers. You awakened to his community of grace, not judgment. No matter what uncertainty you awakened to on this Sunday morning, remember, Christ loves you for who you are, for what you are. Now shine his light. The light of Christ depends on you. Let it shine. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you that we live each day in the light of your love and grace, and we pray that we might not only be thankful, but that we might be ever ready to share it. Amen.
Keep your lamps trimmed and burning. Keep Now let us join in affirming our faith using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now let us join our hearts in prayer. God of light, you created this world in beauty, and you govern in power and in love. We lift our hearts to you now, praying that you draw near to us and sustain us in the abiding grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. God of providence, you hold the nations in your hands. And so we commend to you our country in these times. Save us from discord and confusion and pride. Unite us who are in so many ways different to live as one people, bound together by a spirit of helpfulness and generosity and justice. We pray for leaders that you would bestow upon them wisdom to do their work, mindful of the greater good, and to be agents of peace and understanding throughout the world. We are grateful for those veterans who have given of themselves, even their very lives, to hold fast our liberties. We pray for them and for their families, and we yearn for the day that your kingdom will reign in all its fullness, when the wolf and the lamb shall feed together, and there shall be forever rejoicing. God of mercy, we pray for those who carry burdens of illness, of worry about a loved one, of grief, of loneliness, of uncertainty. May your Spirit enfold them and give them strength and comfort. We pray for our neighbors, those whom we know and those whom we do not, and for our community, in the hardships that they bear, in the challenges of work and family and financial stress, may the light of your presence shine upon them through your people. God of glory, we give you thanks that you have called your church into being, that you have set us here in this time and place to be a part of the witness of the body of Christ. Keep us faithful. Increase our work of caring and teaching, of worship and mission, so that the good news of Jesus Christ may be boldly proclaimed by us and through us, until the day when every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that he is Lord. We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, even as we pray as he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be yours this day and always. Go in peace.